Fox News, and FM Talk Radio, 99.1 KKFT and 99.1FMTalk.com.
Real Life Habits for Success with Jeffrey Benjamin, Sundays at 9:30 a.m. on 99.1 FM Talk and streaming online at 99.1FMTalk.com. BreakthroughTraining.com.
I'm Jeffrey Benjamin. Thanks for tuning in to Breakthrough Radio. Some of the topics you can catch right here are strengthening your leadership, building an unstoppable team, maximizing your time, achieving your goals. These are just some of the topics you can catch right here. And of course, I'm always asking you to take action on this information, because knowing this information won't change or improve the quality of your life. You've got to do something with it in order to get a result. So today I'm excited. I have Matt Westfield, and he's with Startup Growth Strategies, and he is the founder and the managing director, and I've asked him to come in and tell us a little bit about Startup Growth Strategies and to share some of his real life habits for success. So great to have you in the studio today, Matt.
Jeff, thanks. It's always a pleasure, man.
All right, well, tell us a little bit about SGS.
Well, SGS was born from helping some out-of-work professionals kind of rehone their skills to look into entrepreneurship and how they could be better suited to possibly take one of their ideas that they've had for years and bring it possibly to market.
Mm-hmm. And that's really applicable today, too, because a lot of people are out of work, or they had a 9-to-5 for the last 20 years. They probably develop some kind of skill set, develop some kind of product or service, and it's a way for them to take it to market and become an entrepreneur.
It's really wonderful, because people who didn't have the time in the past because of all those things you mentioned can now really look and vet through an idea to see if it's viable. And our opinion is no idea for a new business is a bad one, but we want to know that somebody's going to pay for what you're selling.
Yeah, just because I think I make the greatest homemade pie doesn't mean that other people are going to like it too, and that they're going to actually buy it.
Yeah, and is your pie that much different from the other folks' pie, where somebody would actually choose yours before someone else's that was already in the marketplace, if
yeah,
we're being metaphoric?
Yeah, that is a great point. I know that with me, for my training business, how I really differentiate myself is I'm more about action instead of just sharing content.
It's true.
I'm all about getting people to know the content or get reacquainted with the content, but more importantly, to activate and use that content.
It's perfect, because that's what we talk about, the corridor theory, where you'll never know what's out there unless you put your foot through that door. And once you do, there'll be all kinds of other doors out there. Corridors, the corridor theory. So it's the same thing. Action creates that.
Yeah, you got to get started, even if you don't have all the answers, right?
Huge. That's huge.
All right, well, share with us one of your habits for success for those people out there that are listening today, and maybe they want to move into some entrepreneurial. And then you also have some opportunities to help them develop that skill set as an entrepreneur, too.
We do. We teach quarterly classes up at KNPB Channel 5, and these are four-day workshops. They're very intensive, and we've been told it's like a mini MBA on business entrepreneurship. Then the other thing we've done is we've created, through the same nonprofit, the Entrepreneurs Assembly. And what happens is, I don't care if you take classes with us or SCORE or at the university or TMCC, you still come out of those classes trying to be a business owner. You come out basically naked and alone. And I'm not trying to be facetious, but the bottom line is we try to help guide you along with your new business to keep you on task, on target, monthly.
Yeah, which is great, because just because you have a degree now in, let's say, business administration, that, you know, you may know how to look at a P&L, but maybe you've never actually ran a P&L.
That's exactly
so
right.
You might have, once again, the content or the knowingness, but unless you're consistently practicing it, which is what you guys do, is keep them on track, keep them practicing so that they can constantly get better and use those skills.
And be tenacious. We're all about, you know, being tenacious, and don't spend money in the wrong places. Don't go get a website and business cards before you know that you have a product or service that people are going to buy.
Mm-hmm.
So we try to help people, and I don't mean to be sarcastic, but if you're going to fail, we want you to fail quickly.
Yeah, fail quickly, and or fail on paper too.
That's right. Exactly.
Yeah.
Don't put any money in it.
Uh-huh. Good stuff. All right, so share with us one more habit for success.
Well, don't take yourself too seriously. I'm a firm believer that business is not about business. Business is about people. And I like doing business with people I like, and most people are the same way. Don't take yourself too seriously. Focus on the goals for the customer, and focus on being the best person with the most integrity you can possibly be.
Super habits. All right, Matt, so how does someone get in touch with you if they have an idea to be an entrepreneur, a product or service? How do they get in contact with you?
Great. Great question, Jeff. Best way would be www.sgs101.com. That's SamGeorgeSam101.com. You can also look up ea-nv.org. That's EA for Entrepreneurs Assembly, -nv for Nevada.org.
Matt, thank you so much for coming in and sharing your real-life habits for success. Great to have you in today.
It's always great to see you, Jeff. Thanks.
Breakthrough with Jeffrey Benjamin. BreakthroughTraining.com.